Jack decided to paint his room. In order to get his favorite green color paint, he decided to first mix one bucket of blue paint with two buckets of yellow paint. We say that Jack mixed blue and yellow paints in the ratio 1:2, or yellow and blue paints in the ratio 2:1. This simply means that he mixed one part of blue paint to two parts of yellow paint. He wanted to make sure he liked the shade before mixing more paint. He then started painting his room. Once he was sure he was happy with the effect produced, he decided to mix more paint. This time, he decided to use three buckets of blue paint. In order to get the same shade of green, he added six buckets of yellow paint, which is twice as much as the blue paint. We can say that Jack mixed more blue and yellow paints in the same ratio, that is, 1:2. Now let us find out how much yellow paint Jack would use if he decides to use four buckets of blue paint in order to get his favorite green color. The ratio tells us that Jack mixes two buckets of yellow paint with each bucket of blue paint. So for four buckets of blue paint, Jack would use 4 × 2, or 8 buckets of yellow paint. Ratio is a convenient way to compare two or more quantities relatively. Proportion gives us an idea as to how two or more quantities are being combined or mixed. We generally draw models of the ratio in order to understand and solve problems easily. Since the ratio of the blue and yellow paint is 1:2, we can draw a model of the blue and yellow paints this way. Note that in this model, we represent the ratio 1:2 by drawing 1 unit for the blue paint and 2 units for the yellow paint. This model helps us visually to understand the proportion between the blue paint and yellow paint. From this model, it's clear that the yellow paint is twice as much as the blue paint, or the blue paint is half as much as the yellow paint. Let us now see the relationship between ratios and fractions. We can say that Jack used 1/2, or half, as much blue paint as yellow paint. We can also say that Jack used 2/1, or 2 times as much yellow paint as blue paint. Equivalent ratios are similar to equivalent fractions. We know that 2/4, 3/6, and 4/8 are the same, as all these fractions are equal to 1/2. Similarly, 2:4, 3:6, and 4:8 are the same, as all these ratios are 1:2 in their simplest form. The following example will explain this more clearly. Ahmed has 12 red marbles and 8 yellow marbles. The ratio of the red marbles to the yellow marbles may be given as 12 is to 8. Now, let us group them 2 by 2. We see the ratio can now be expressed as 6 is to 4. Next, let us group them 4 by 4. Now the ratio can be expressed as 3 is to 2. This helps us to understand that the ratios 12 is to 8, 6 is to 4, and 3 is to 2 are all the same. Since 3 and 2 do not have any common factor other than 1, the ratio 3 is to 2 cannot be simplified any further, and is hence said to be in its simplest form. It is also possible to use a single ratio to compare three quantities. Let us say Amanda has 2 apples, 8 oranges, and 6 mangoes. We can say that the ratio of the number of apples to oranges to mangoes she has is 2 is to 8 is to 6. But this can be simplified as 1 is to 4 is to 3. So we say that the ratio of the number of apples to oranges to mangoes she has is 1 is to 4 is to 3. Or that the ratio of the number of mangoes to apples to oranges is 3 is to 1 is to 4. Note that we have to be very careful with the order in which we give the ratio. If A is to B is equal to 2 is to 3, and B is to C is equal to 3 is to 4, can you guess what is A is to B is to C? Since the number of units of B is the same in both ratios, we can simply say that A is to B is to C is equal to 2 is to 3 is to 4. In a different situation, let us say if the number of units of B in the second ratio is different, for example, 5. Can you guess what would be A is to B is to C? In order to find A is to B is to C, we have to change the number of units of B in both ratios to the same number without changing the proportion of the two quantities in both cases. Let us now learn how to do that. Look at the number of units of B in both ratios. Since 15 is a common multiple of 3 and 5, we change both the ratios in such a way that B becomes 15 units without changing the actual proportion of the two ratios. Let us take the first ratio. We know that B is 3 units. In order to make it 15 units, we need to multiply 3 by 5. 3 times 5 is 15. Since we multiply the second part of the ratio by 5, we must multiply the first part of the ratio by 5 in order to maintain the original proportion. 2 multiplied by 5 is equal to 10. Therefore, the first ratio is now 10 is to 15. We have modified our first ratio in such a way that B is 15 units. Let us change the second ratio now. We know that in the second ratio, B is 5 units. In order to make it 15 units, we need to multiply 5 by 3. 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. Since we multiply the first part of the ratio by 3, we must multiply the second part of the ratio by 3 as well, in order to maintain the original proportion. 4 multiplied by 3 is equal to 12. Therefore, the second ratio is now 15 is to 12. Since the value of B is the same in both ratios, we can now compare the three quantities easily. A is to B is to C is equal to 10 is to 15 is to 12. James and Kelly shared 70 stamps in the ratio 4 is to 3. The ratio 4 is to 3 tells us that there are 7 units altogether, out of which James has 4 units and Kelly 3 units. In order to find the number of stamps each person has, we need to first find the number of stamps in one unit. We can find this by dividing the total number of stamps by the total number of units. 70 divided by 7 is equal to 10. Therefore, one unit is equal to 10 stamps. We know that James has 4 units of the stamps. So 10 times 4 is equal to 40. Therefore, James has 40 stamps. Similarly, the number of units Kelly has is 3. 10 times 3 is equal to 30. Therefore, Kelly has 30 stamps. We know that the ratio of the stamps James and Kelly have is 4 is to 3. Let us say Kelly got 15 more stamps from her father. In this situation, the ratio can no longer be the same, since the proportion of stamps between James and Kelly has changed. Let us now find the ratio of the stamps they finally have. Initially, James has 40 stamps and Kelly has 30 stamps. When Kelly receives 15 stamps from her father, the total number of stamps she has becomes 45. Now we can say that the new ratio of the stamps James has to the number Kelly has is 40 is to 45. When we simplify this, we get 8 is to 9. Note that although the total stamps James has did not change, the ratio does not show the same number of units for him before and after. This is because ratio only gives us the relationship between the quantities involved and not their actual values. Let us now solve a more challenging problem. Adam and Becky shared a total of $80 in the ratio 3 is to 2. After Adam spent a certain amount of money, the ratio became 5 is to 4. Can you guess the amount spent by Adam? Observe that the amount Becky had before and after remained the same. Still, the number of units Becky had later has apparently changed. We take the help of a model to understand this. Since Becky's amount did not change, we divide the 2 units Becky has into 4 units. Since all units are to be of the same size, we convert the 3 units for Adam into 6, as seen in the model. Since the new ratio is 5:4, we conclude that Adam has spent 1 unit. Since the total amount is $80, we find that 10 units is $80, meaning 1 unit is $8. We therefore conclude that the amount spent by Adam was $8.